Azerbaijan. Some see it as the East of Europe, others as Europe of the East. Located on the Silk Road throughout history, it established close relations with the representatives of different ethnic groups and civilizations. Zoroastrianism, Judaism, Christianity, and a number of other religions could spread in the country. Since the 7th, 8th centuries, Islam has predominated here. No religious or racial conflicts have ever happened in the country. Representatives of other nations, who for different reasons migrated to the country, have never undergone moral suppression, created their religious places of worship, added new elements to the structure of the society. State care for the religion and believers grew up by the nationwide leader Heydar Aliyev, who made the modern history of Azerbaijan, came to power for the second time. This policy has been continued successfully. Though most of the people are adherents of Islam, representatives of other faiths practice their religion and carry out the religious rites without any restrictions. More than 30 out of hundreds of religious communities are non-Islamic.
Defalarla hemkarlarım ve temasta olduğum harici konaklar bunun sirrini öğrenmek için bana suallar verirdiler. Bunun sirri çok sadedir. Sadece olarak düzgün siyaset yapılmalıdır. İnkişaf olmalıdır. Savadlılık artmalıdır. Milli ve dini siyaset düzgün aparılmalıdır ve Azerbaycan'da yaşayan bütün halkların, bütün dinlerin numaraları özlerini rahat hissetmelidirler.
Azerbaijan is one of the few countries where, irrespective of affiliation, representatives of all religions come together as one family on religious holidays. It is common for the people to congratulate one another on the occasion of Yom Kippur, Christmas, or Eid al-Fitr, while in most parts of the world, religious holidays have become a tool for provocation. What is more important is that leaders of all religious communities of the country come together, have meals, and demonstrate solidarity at the iftar dinner. Another example, procession of a copy of Sefer Torah through Baku streets equally rejoice not only Jews, but also other representatives of the public. Azerbaijan also plays an important role in building religious harmony, strengthening brotherhood and cooperation in the South Caucasus. President Ilham Aliyev has a sensitive approach to the welfare of the peoples of the region, attaches great importance to the development of national and moral values for the future of the Caucasus. Azerbaijan is one of the few Muslim countries which play an active role in the protection and restoration of tangible cultural monuments in the non-Muslim countries. This tolerance is also praised by the world's religious leaders. The meetings Pope Francis held during his visit to Baku, his talk with the heads of religious communities at the Heydar Mosque, the place of worship of the Muslims, demonstrated how interreligious relations should be established. The meeting of the Christian and Islamic leaders at the mosque showed to the whole world that dialogue is the most important stage in the promotion of multiculturalism. If both sides unite their efforts for the establishment of peace between two civilizations, harmony of the mankind can be resumed. Azerbaijan, which is preserving the model of Reyes statehood, is also an active promoter of this model in the world. In 2008, new steps were taken to strengthen intercultural dialogue on the initiative of President Ilham Aliyev. For the first time in history, Azerbaijan, being one of the few countries which are the members both of the Council of Europe and Organization of Islamic Cooperation, established relations between the two organizations. The Baku process was launched in 2008 as the culture ministers of Muslim countries were invited to the Council of Europe Conference of Ministers responsible for culture in Baku. With a view of drawing attention of the local and international community to the elimination of divergence of opinion, promoting successful experience in a broad area, 2016 was declared as the year of multiculturalism and 2017 as the year of Islamic solidarity.
Azerbaijan's commitment to the cause of advancement of youth and sports in member states, but also its active participation toward strengthening multiculturalism.
The concept of solidarity envisages boosting cooperation, not stirring up discrimination or creating coalition against other cultures. The religious leader was the first to react to the call to build this cooperation. Head of the Caucasian Muslims Board, Allah Shukr Pashazadeh, initiated an academic approach to the issue.
dünya devletlerinde bilindiği kadar birçok yerlerde dini liderler olarak hemreliğe davet etmiş. İster Katolik kilisesi, ister Hristiyan Yahudi ve başka dini liderler tarafından ilanlar olmuş ama devlet rehberi kimi, bilimci olarak, siyasi kadim kimi bizim devlet başçımız İlham Aliyev Hazretleri ilan etti.
Ay davru ben rashi hadatot imi biya bracha la'olam.
Within a short period of time, the Baku process turned from a regional initiative into a global challenge. World Forum on Intercultural Dialogue, Baku International Humanitarian Forums are regularly held as part of the process. Moreover, Baku hosted the Summit of the World Religious Leaders and Global Forum of the UN Alliance of Civilizations. According to the statistics, over the recent years, 70% of the terrorist attacks worldwide were committed in Islamic countries, 5% in Europe, the rest in other countries. But due to the mechanism of propaganda shaping the public opinion, information covers the minority and subsequently 5% causes more uproar than 70%.
The first to suffer from terrorism is Islam. And I think that terrorists have no religion at all.
امروز همبستگی اسلامی و وحدت اسلامی به یک گفتمان غالب داره تبدیل میشه.
دین هیزمتلری açısından hem dine eğitim açısından hem de iki ülke arasındaki diğer konularda yardımlaşma noktasında terörle mücadele noktasında her zaman işbirliğimiz devam edecektir.
One of the main objectives of the joint conferences held in Finland, Sweden, Iran, Turkey, Spain, Russia, Uzbekistan, Germany, Egypt and others was to draw attention of the international community to Azerbaijan's main problem, solution to Armenia-Azerbaijan Nagorno-Karabakh conflict. Protraction of this conflict poses a serious threat to the entire region. Despite the resolutions of the UN Security Council, Organization of Islamic Cooperation and a number of other organizations, Armenia continues its aggressive policy. Religious leaders also spare no efforts for the peaceful solution to Nagorno-Karabakh conflict. The meetings of Azerbaijani and Armenian religious leaders have been held through the mediation of the Russian Orthodox Church to solve the problem in a peaceful way and primarily to prevent it from turning into religious conflict. Attempts to describe this conflict as a Christian-Muslim confrontation are always doomed to failure. The notions of national and religious tolerance are on the same moral level in Azerbaijan and are based on the historical traditions of the people.
Есть силы, которые хотели бы использовать религиозную мотивацию для осуществления своих агрессивных планов. И это очень опасно, потому что религиозные чувства – это очень сильные чувства, национальные и религиозные. Нет ничего более сильного. Люди готовы жизнь отдать за родину, за веру.
Карабах мәселесіне Азербайджанның аразы бүтөвлігі чәрчевесінде сүлх жолы ілі хәл олынмасының бір тарафтарыйым.
The initiative of solidarity is first of all a call to morality which sees no borders. In all the events held over the recent years, Azerbaijan chose the most effective means of promotion, the model of its real life. Late in 2017, Baku hosted the conference that brought together up to 150 foreign guests from about 40 countries. With the view of ensuring durability of President Ilham Aliyev's call for universal peace, the participants of the conference put forward an initiative to establish Baku International Center for Cooperation among Religions and Civilizations. The center was established under the Caucasian Muslims Board within a short period of time and has already started functioning.
Солидарность, которую объявляет президент страны Ильхам Гейдарович, это очень много стоит.
Увару камышимазе, сипай суру камышимазе, сикай суэту кантянаку, тоникаку отагайга.
I think today more than any time before, we have to come together to think of how this increasingly plural world can find a handle, can find a way.
Ümumi məqsədimiz ondan ibarətdir ki, dünyada sülh olsun, qarşılıqlı hürmət olsun, qarşılıqlı anlaşma olsun, ölkələr bir-birinin işinə qarışmasın. Belə olan halda müharibələr də olmayacaq və sülh bütün dünyada bərqərar olacaq.